In the fall of 2020, Michigan State University began working to establish a dedicated science network that will further its mission as a leading research university. The Science Network will help MSU researchers work collaboratively to tackle global challenges affecting the environment, agriculture, and health and wellness.
Research is becoming increasingly data-driven. A high-speed science network opens up significant opportunities for Michigan State. Being able to move around huge amounts of research data very quickly allows MSU researchers to communicate and engage with researchers across the world more efficiently than they used to.
MSU Assistant Professor Dr. Addie Thompson is eager to utilize the Science Network to aid her research in understanding the interaction between plant genetics and different environments.
One of the ways that we're excited to use the Science Network is to share data amongst our collaborators and stakeholders. We've got a large group of about 24 people on campus, but also external collaborators and even industry groups that we work with on a regular basis. And being able to move that data around quickly and efficiently would be very helpful. And part of the power of that collaboration then is that we share those resources and data sets afterwards. And moving that data around amongst that large collaborative network has been difficult. And I am looking forward to having a science network that's capable of handling that kind of data transfer.
MSU physics professor, Dr. Daniel Hayden, has already realized the global impacts of the Science Network through his work with CERN in Switzerland.
My main focus of research is to use the ATLAS detector at something called the Large Hadron Collider, which is based at CERN in Switzerland, to collide protons together at very close to the speed of light and try and understand the fundamental building blocks of nature. At the LHC, we collide protons together at nearly a million times per second. And that's going on 24 hours a day, 7 days a week while we're running. So as you can imagine, we're collecting an awful lot of data in that. We can actually only write 1,000 collisions per second to disk because that's some limitations. So to analyze all of this data, we have something called the GRID, which is a worldwide system of computing centers that analyze this data at different levels of complexity, essentially. And Michigan State University is one of those sites. We actually partner also with the University of Michigan, and more recently we'll be collaborating also with Wayne State University. And what the DMZ has brought to this is essentially increased networking between these three sites. Another thing is it has also allowed us to have some redundancy. So instead of just going around one way, we can now send data the other way around that link, and so the connections are never broken. The second area of networking that it brings is that there is a second triangle, essentially, between us here at MSU and Chicago.
MSUIT will continue to help bring more of the Science Network online this year, providing greater access to MSU researchers and beyond.
MSUIT has been critical to the success of this project. As part of this collaboration, we have had to acquire and deploy a ton of new network equipment that connects MSU's perimeter network to the High Performance Computing Center and to the research laboratories of all of the investigators that are involved in the project. The partnership between MSUIT, ICER, and the researchers that were involved was really productive. This was a large and complicated project that involves a lot of the university's cyber infrastructure and MSUIT's project management during this whole process was really crucial to the success.